Hey Sprouts, during the months of June and July, we will not be having new content here on the Catholic Sprouts podcast. Instead, we will be revisiting some of my favorite weeks of content. And here is one of those weeks. Enjoy! You're listening to
Catholic Sprouts,
the daily podcast for Catholic kids that strives to plant seeds of faith. Hey there, Sprouts. Today is Monday, May 6th, 2019. This week on the Catholic Sprouts podcast, we are going to be talking about a beautiful revelation that God gave to Saint Faustina many years ago. It is called the Divine Mercy. We just celebrated the feast day of the Divine Mercy exactly 1 week after Easter, and although we have to wait nearly a year to celebrate that feast day again, the Divine Mercy is something that should bring us peace and joy every day of the year. Now, there is a lot to talk about with the Divine Mercy, and we are going to be spending all week on this topic. But before we get into that, today we are going to talk about the idea of mercy. What does mercy mean? What is it? Well, let's start here. Mercy, we are told in the Catechism, is basically the gospel. Everything that we read in the Bible, especially in the Gospels, which are the story of Jesus Christ's time on earth, is a revelation of God's love for us, or we could also say a revelation of His mercy for us. In fact, the words love and mercy are deeply linked. Pope Benedict said that mercy is love's second name. In other words, mercy is just simply a type of love. Mercy, in fact, is the type of love that occurs when love enters a situation where there is suffering, pain, and sin. So, whenever we come into a situation where someone is suffering physical, mental, or spiritual pain, where someone is dealing with a type of sin, or someone is just in a suffering stage, if we come into that situation and we comfort them or try to just be with them in any way, then we are loving them and we are showing mercy. Now, in a very real way, the only way that God loves us is through an act of mercy. The entire time that we will spend on this earth, our whole life will have some level of suffering, some level of pain, and we know that despite our best efforts, we continue to sin every day. So Jesus coming to earth and dying for us was a profound act of loving mercy. God coming to us each time we enter into personal prayer is mercy. Jesus being truly present in the Eucharist every single time that we go to Mass, that is mercy. God loves us enough to be with us even in our pain, our suffering, and our sin. So that is what mercy is. Now, the divine mercy means God's mercy. He, of course, is the divine, is something that was revealed to a Polish saint named Saint Faustina. Now, the divine mercy, both the image of the divine mercy, the prayer, the feast day, the novena, all of these things have come about in the last 100 years. But the idea of mercy is not a new idea. Jesus came to earth to show mercy. The gospel is about mercy. So then why do we have this new devotion called the Divine Mercy? Why did God come to Saint Faustina just a little under 100 years ago? Well, He came to remind us of something that He had been speaking about since the beginning of time. People had lost track of mercy, And the divine mercy is simply a way for us to remember it and to live in God's wonderful ocean of loving mercy. So we're going to talk about this today. We're going to break down all the pieces of the divine mercy this week. But before I go, I have a challenge for you, my friends. And it's to say this prayer. Now, this is a prayer from a parable that Jesus tells in the gospel. In this parable, there is a Pharisee and a tax collector. They both have gone to the temple, and they both are praying, although we're told by Jesus that one is praying well and one is not praying well. The Pharisee is very proud and very in love with himself. He pretends or seems to think he's praying, but really he's just singing his own praises and looking down on other people. Meanwhile, the tax collector, who were seen as notorious sinners at the time, says this simple prayer. He casts down his eyes and he says simply, God, have mercy on me, a poor sinner. God, have mercy on me, a poor sinner. We're told from Jesus that this is the perfect prayer. And this is a prayer that we should be saying every day. Despite how much we love Jesus, we continue to sin. And we know that the way he loves us is by sending mercy. And so, Sprouts, that is your challenge. Say this simple prayer. God, have mercy on me, a poor sinner.
That's it for Catholic Sprouts today. We'll be back tomorrow, but until then, continue to grow in your faith and truly sprout into the beautiful creation that God intended you to be. And finally, a quick note to the grown-ups. First of all, thank you for listening to the Catholic Sprouts podcast. I ask that you please consider sharing this podcast with another Catholic family you know. Send them an email, a text, or simply mention it the next time you see them. Please join me in the mission of helping each Catholic child truly sprout into the wonderful human that God created them to be.